It's a popular pastime, and people in Seoul claim to be the founding mothers and fathers of the selfie.
I bought a selfie stick and use it when I'm out with my girlfriend. I want the background to be included when we go out to tourist attractions, so I use a selfie stick, which can frame a bigger picture.
I always take a selfie when I look good, when my makeup or clothes look good, and I'm going out. I don't have a stick, but I think it's cool.
Here in Korea, this global pastime is facing a crackdown. Well, at least the selfie stick is. Is it because it's annoying, narcissistic, and looks like the odd? Or is it because it's more fun watching people struggle to get the shot, all fingers and thumbs, while they strike a pose? No, the Korean government says that it's concerned that some Bluetooth selfie sticks may interfere with industrial, scientific, and crucially, medical equipment. So it's cracking down to ensure that every stick and retailer is registered and certified. Bluetooth selfie sticks operate on a frequency of 2.4 gigahertz, same as your Wi-Fi router at home, with a range of 10 meters. But the concern is uncertified sticks might exceed that limit and interfere with nearby equipment.
My friends told me about this, and I thought I'd better go buy one quickly.
I hadn't heard about the government crackdown, and I had no idea the sticks can affect medical equipment.
Any retailer importing or selling selfie sticks without government certification could face a fine of up to $30,000 or 3 years in prison. Time to take taking a selfie in Seoul very seriously. Simon Morse, CNN, Seoul, South Korea.